Hi guys and girls, it is Corneille. Today is the 26th of July 2016. I'm going to show you guys the trades I took today on the 1-2-3 pattern. I haven't tried much, 4 trades, 3 wins, 1 loss, but there was more setups. I'm going to show you guys why I missed them, why I didn't took them. Right, let me go to the first one. Right, here we see this, I think it was on the Australia USD. Price, you see, it hit that line, it came back, it hit it twice, I draw a trend line, and then we mark them. 1, 2, this is the third bar, you see, it hit that, and it retraced. So, we do expect this bar will come down. But what happened here, this bar, the setup qualified because it opened under the trend line, which we want, and then we see this bar breaks the trend line, which is exit. And then this bar, as it came to this level, this is a swing high here. It also happened at the 75.8 Fibonacci level. I took there a put, but I've entered a little early, and then price went up all the way. And as I expected, the price will retrace. And it retraced, but just above that swing, it closed. And that leaves me with a loss. So that was my loss of the day. And what I learned about this thing is, when you get the swing here, don't draw this line on that level. Look for the lowest of this point, pins. You see there, there's a pin, there's a pin, there's a pin, there's a pin, there's a pin. If I enter at this level, you see there's bear bar of a pin here. If I draw this blue line there, then it would be a win. So, just above the swing, not at the swing, just above the swing. So this was the point actually where I should have drawn my line, then that would be a win as well. Let me show you guys the rest. Okay, this one, very nice. You see price hit, draw that line, then this pin hit it again, I draw a trend line. And look at this bar, it respects that trend line. So, the next bar, does it qualify? To qualify, it have to close under the trend line, which it did. Then it breaks the trend line, the second condition. But very, very important, what I want to show you guys, this yellow line is a round number. Now, we don't want to enter at the round number, because sometimes the price close at the round number. So, where do I enter? If you look left, you see there's a bear bar with a pin there. That pin or that pin is great. It's outside the trend line. And if I draw right, also happen to be at the 78 Fibonacci. You enter a put there. And because it leave that week behind, it's a win. So that was on, I think, on the Euro JPY. Now, let's go to the next setup. Oh yeah, this was beautiful. This one, I think it happened on the Euro USD. You see, price is in a downtrend now, coming down, goes up, draw a trend line from that week till this week, and then we look at this bar. This bar came, hit the trend line, and I respect it. So this is my touch free. Only work on the first 3 touches. This, touch the trend line once, touch it twice, touch it 3 times. Right, but I don't enter a put when this bar open. I want a better point of entry. Now, first of all, look here. Did this setup qualify? To qualify, this bar, the entry bar, have to close under the trend line, which it did. Then it have to break the trend line, second condition. And the third condition is I'm looking for a point to enter. Now, can you guys see these 2 pins here? And I draw a line there, and this is where I enter. Now, if you look left, you'll be very surprised how many times that level is being respected. Look here. Very interesting. So, as price came to that area, I enter a put for the remaining period. Remember, this is 30-minute bars. So, this price has to come in here within the first 18 minutes. If it happened after 18 minutes, I don't take the trade. So, let's assume this bar came here and hit it exactly 18 minutes past the 30-minute period. Then you enter a put here only for the remaining period, which is 12 minutes. This is how it works. So those were the trades which I took. And this one, Oh, no, no, this one I also took. All right, as this bar closed, that previous trade, which I win, I also observed, look here, we have two inside bars, price goes down, two inside bars. So I expect this bar will go down. This is what we call a repeat pattern. And it happened on touch three again, look here, touch one, touch two, touch three. So I don't trade repeat patterns, I just use it as a confirmation to give me confidence. That bar will repeat itself, this pattern. The pattern is two bull bars, one bar down. Two bull bars, one bar down. This is what I expect. But I don't want to enter as this bar open. I'm looking for a better point of entry. In this case, it was the same level here. You see that happens there? As price come to that level, I enter a put for remaining period. I think this, as this bar open, it happened in the first 3 minutes. It hit that area, I enter there, and what an easy, comfortable win it was. Alright, those were the three trades I took today, but there was more setups. This one I didn't take. Let me tell you guys the setup. You see, I look at these two pins, I draw a line, and I look at this bar. It came all the way down. It respects the trend line. This is what we call exhausted bar. Now, on exhausted bar, we do expect the next bar will go up, but I don't want to enter immediately. I also noticed there's a round number, this yellow number. So I don't want to enter at the round number. I'm looking for a point under the round number. It can be one of these pins there, or this one. But what I notice we have some swing here. You see here, this area here, I draw a line there. This could be my resistance. I wait for the price to come here in the first 18 minutes. Never came there. Just maybe I think it tests this pin here, and then it goes up. But it was not in that trade. But that was one of the setups I was prepared to take. This one I totally missed, more or less the same one as the previous one, which I won. Look at the principle, one touch, two touch, three touch, this bar open under the trend line, breaks the trend line, and as it comes to this pin here, you could enter a put there. And because of market retrace, even it's bullish, it is a win. And then this next thing I also want to point out is there's also a pattern after three bars, one, two, three bars. Next bar go down, look here, one, two, three bars, next bar go down. So there's a pattern, and because this is the inside bar, I expect this bar, if this bar going to test that area, you take another trade, there's another one. More or less the same one as the previous one which I showed. So there was two trades on that one. I missed that one for some reason. This one I watch. I'll tell you what happened here. You see market went up to this level. Trend is down. And as market come to this level, it retrace. It tested twice. And this was the third time it tested. Now this is what a very big bar is, like exhausted bar. It looks like it closed on the resistance line there. Above it, 21, I hesitate on this one. I thought, well, I'm not going to take the risk. I leave it, but look here, it was a winner. So you enter a put day, leaving this bar will go down. Yesterday, I took more or less a trade like this. It did come down, and then it goes up before the market closed, and that's why I decided not to take this trade. There was one more I want to show you guys. This one. Alright, this one, I watch it. I couldn't trade it. One of the rules is, because if three star news is coming out, we don't take the trade. And as this bar opened, it was 4 o'clock, 3 star news did came out. So I just watch it. But actually, you know, it was a beautiful win. What I want to point out here, why I believe it would win. First of all, look at the three touches. The trend is down. Market came to this level, then it retraced first time, it hit it again, twice, came down, and now this is the third touch. You see, there's a third touch, and I also noticed there's a pattern. Look at the pattern, 1, 2, 3 bars, one bar go down, and I count to 1, 2, 3. So I do expect this bar will go down, and this bar is almost an inside bar, so that gives me the confidence. Where do I enter? You see, the price break the trend line there, and with this red line is any, you see this weeks here, the lowest of this weeks is fine enough. This is where you enter the put day, and that would be easy win. But as I say, this happened as news came out, Freestyle News. So yesterday I also took a trade when Freestyle News come out and the thing goes the wrong direction. So I rather avoid it. It's one of the rules. Okay guys, hope you have picked up something and enjoy your day.